Question number 5 here. So what we want to do is we have this function below. We want to find all the values of x that are not in the domain. So that means x values that we can't plug in here because that would cause something mathematically to be wrong. And so one of the things we can't do in math is divide by zero. That's an undefined operation. You could define it to be infinity, but infinity is not a real number, so we don't. We call that undefined, so we take those things out of the domain. So we're looking just at the denominator. Whatever happens in the numerator is going to be just fine. Any number you plug for x, you can square it, you multiply by 12, you'll get a number. But the problem is if the bottom, the denominator, becomes zero. So let's figure out, where is x squared minus 4? Where does that equal zero? Multiple ways we can solve this. One way, we could add 4 to both sides, so you have x squared equals 4. Then you could take the square root of both sides, but you have to remember, when you do that, you get a plus and a minus answer. So you could think that would be x is now equal to either plus or negative 2. So there's the two answers, which we would list as negative 2, 2. The other way is you could factor. This is a difference of squares, so this would be x plus 2 times x minus 2. I like doing it this way because then you don't have to remember about the plus or minus, but just kind of this. But notice, positive 2 times negative 2, that gives you negative 4. You'll get x squared times x gives you the x squared, and the middle term gives you negative 2x plus 2x, so that becomes 0, that drops out, right? So I just did, I multiplied out to check. Yeah, that gets me back to x squared minus 4. So this will work. Yeah, just delete that part while we're at it. And so then we've got this sort of principle. If two numbers multiply to give you 0, then each of them could be 0. So x plus 2 equals 0, or x minus 2 could be 0, or both at the same time. Well, probably not at the same time. Anyway, this one you subtract 2 from both sides, and you get that x equals negative 2. This one you add 2 to both sides, so you get x equals positive 2. Again, our two answers that we're going to get for these are numbers that are not in the domain. Just so you can kind of see ahead, sometimes we ask you to do this with interval notation. So we want to take out negative 2 and 2 from the number line. So we don't want those numbers in our domain. We want everything else except those two. Here's positive infinity, there's negative infinity. So for interval notation, we would list this as negative infinity to negative 2, union negative 2 to 2, union 2 to infinity. Okay, but for this question, they didn't ask that this would be our answer right here. Okay, just show you all the possibilities.